so great to be back with you, and I'm very excited. Yes. This month we're talking about creativity.
Whoa, creativity.
Yes, creativity is imagining what you could do because you're made in God's image.
Yes.
You know, Pastor James, I know sometimes you can be very creative in some of the ways that you've drawn pictures.
Sure.
Even, you know, some of the skits that you've made.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I like being creative through writing song. And some of you might be really creative through dance or through many other ways, or even how you demonstrate love towards one another. And
yes.
So we're going to be talking about creativity this month. And, you know, I'm really excited because we serve an indescribable God.
Yes.
And we know this to be true because of this amazing world that he created. So today mm-hmm. we're going to be looking at the historical account from the book of Genesis.
Oh, yes. Genesis, the very first book in the Bible.
So if you have your Bibles with me, we're going to be looking at this historical God-breathed word in the book of Genesis. And of course, we're going to be looking at Genesis 1:1 to start. It says, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." Now, I like it because it says God created the heavens and the earth, which is great. But it doesn't just, the author doesn't just stop there. He goes on and he describes everything that he created. And so in verse 3, it says, "And God said, let there be light. And there was light." Imagine if there was nothing and there was just darkness.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, there was light.
Close your eyes and then open them.
Exactly. You know, Pastor James says this really cool saying in his office. It says, "In the beginning, there was nothing. And God said, let there be light."
Yes.
You can see a lot better, but there still wasn't anything yet, right?
Nope.
They're just light.
That's right. It's like an empty room. You walk in when you first move into a house, and you turn on the light switches, and you haven't put anything in the room. It's just empty.
That's right.
Yeah.
But then he had created the light, and God saw that it was good. And he separated the light from the darkness, and he called the light day.
Mm-hmm.
And the darkness night. And then that was the first day, the first whole day, because there was evening and morning.
Yes.
So it didn't just remain, okay, there's evening, there's morning, and that's it. No, 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 it goes on. And then in verse 6, it says, "And God said, let there be an expanse or space between the waters to separate different bodies of water." So God made the separation. And it was so, and God called the expanse sky, so the space between their sky
and way up high,
way up high, absolutely. And that was the next day. And then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into one place, and let dry ground appear." And it was so. And God called the dry land ground land, and gathered the waters, and called the waters see.
Mm-hmm.
He saw it was good. Then he said, so not just that. So God, out of nothing, created land and waters. Mm-hmm. And then he also created vegetation. The Bible says, and God then said, "Let the land produce vegetation and seed-bearing plants and trees." You know, this time of year, we get to see all kinds.
We get to see all of that.
Cherries. We have tons of cherries.
And lots of cherries.
Strawberries and raspberries.
Yeah.
All
apples.
Kinds. Apples.
Grapes.
Amazing things, creative. And God thought of and created every single one of them. You know, when I think of a raspberry, just each little nodule that is on a raspberry, it's so amazing.
Yeah.
And he created those in the midst of all of this.
Or a strawberry with all those things in it. It's amazing.
And once he spoke it, it was so. Plants bearing seed according to their kinds of trees, bearing fruit according to their seed, according to those kinds.
Yes.
And he saw it was good. There was morning, and then there was evening. That was the third day.
Wow.
Again,
that's a lot of stuff.
So far, he's created so much.
So much.
Light, the sky, the land, the waters, vegetation. It's so amazing.
And so much power.
So much. God
just
is
with
so
a
creative.
Word.
Just by a spoken word, absolutely.
Yeah.
And then God said, "Let there be lights in the expanse of the sky to separate the day from the night.
Oh.
And let them serve as signs to mark seasons and days and years. And let them be lights in expanse of the sky to give light to the earth." And it
That's
was so.
Right.
You know,
it was so.
And God made two great lights. Now, yes. What kind of lights do you think he made?
Well, it wasn't light bulbs. I know that's mm-hmm. what we're kind of accustomed to. You know, when you're inside, you got light bulbs. You go outside, you got street lights. But he wasn't creating light bulbs and street lights. He was creating something that was more permanent. Nothing that had to ever be replaced. You know, you got to replace light bulbs. But
yeah, what he created he did not. The sun, and that gives nutrients to those beautiful plants he created, and the moon, and those beautiful constellations that we can look out.
Yeah. Like the Big Dipper?
Yeah, he created such beautiful constellations, mm-hmm. and that was day four. On day five, he created fish. He said,
fish.
And God said, let the water teem with living creatures. And this is in verse 20. And let the birds fly above the earth and across the expanse of the sky. Mm-hmm. So God created great creatures in the sea.
That's right.
And every living and moving thing which was in the waters according to their kinds.
Yeah.
He saw it was good. And it was, and he blessed it. And he said, be fruitful and increase in numbers.
That's right.
And fill the water and the seas and let the birds increase in the earth. That was on the fifth day.
Look at that. For all you that like to go fishing, look at that. That was the day that he put all the fish and everything in there. And for all you bird watchers, all right there. We got lots of birds all over the place, all over our house. We got lots of birds.
Yes, and he's very creative. He thought of many different types, many different kinds. Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
And he didn't stop there. There's another day of creation. On the sixth day of creation. Okay, on the sixth day of creation. He created the wild animals and the livestock and every creative thing that moves on the ground. So if you, like cows and horses and all those amazing creatures and all kinds of animals God created. It is so amazing that he thought the difference between a lion and a leopard and a tiger. And a giraffe, elephants, cats, all kinds of things. He was so creative. But that's not all that he created on that sixth day.
No?
Mm-mm.
Really? I mean, that's some pretty all unique things when you're just looking at all
the
animals.
Very unique, very unique. He created the livestock, as I said, and the wild animals.
Yeah.
And then God said, let us make man in our image and in our likeness. And let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and over the livestock and over the earth and over all the creatures that move on the ground. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created them, male and female.
Mm.
He created them. And then he blessed them in verse 28 and said, be fruitful and increase in number and fill the earth. Isn't that wonderful? God, it was so. God saw that he had made and it was good. And there was evening and there was morning. But see, in this first week, he didn't just do that. There was something else. You know, we have 7 days in our week, and there's a purposeful piece in that.
Mm-hmm.
You see, in chapter 2, verse 1, it says, thus the heavens and the earth were completed in their vast array. By the seventh day, God finished the work he had been doing. And on the seventh day, he rested from all his work.
Mm-hmm.
And God blessed the seventh day. He made it holy because on it he rested from all the work of creating. It was a lot of work.
Yeah.
But you know what? From nothing, God created everything.
Yeah.
Everything that we can imagine, everything that was out, like he thought it through. I love human anatomy, how the body works. Mm-hmm. And it's amazing that we serve a God that thought how our whole body works, how all the muscles and bones and our blood vessels and everything. And he did that for all the creatures. We serve a creative God.
Yeah.
He really is indescribable.
Mm-hmm.
So our verse this month, it really points to our wonderfully creative God. Our verse this month is from Psalm 145, verse 3. It says, Lord, you are great. You are really worthy of praise. No one can completely understand how great you are. You know, throughout life, I constantly see time and time again how wonderful God is. I love being out in nature and seeing his creation. What about you, Pastor James? Do you like going out in nature? And
I do. I've been really, absolutely loving it. And I love, like, from when you get to see the mountains on the nice clear day, I just, every time I look at the mountains, I can't help but just look at and think of God and how He has created so many beautiful things. And we got the big Rocky Mountains, and we got trees, we even got the coulees, and how it's all designed. It is all just amazing, and each and everything is beautiful, but all different. And God is so good. And just like when we look at each and every one of us, we might all have a little bit of a difference, but He has created each and every one of us special and unique and a part of Him.
Absolutely. Let's pray.
Indeed. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You for today. We thank You that You love us, that You care for us, and that we can look at Your Word. And in the very first chapter, in the very first verse, it just talks about how powerful Your spoken Word is. Lord, may we remember every time we look around, every time we go outside, every time we look at our brothers or sisters or mom or dad or family, that we would remember You and how good You are and how much You care about us and love us, and that You are so creative, and that You have made us all creative in different ways. Through music, through art, through math, through all the different things, sports, and the list just goes on and on. Lord, it is so amazing what You have done, and may we never forget Your great love that You have for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Well, it's so wonderful that we get to continue to talk about creativity this month.
That's right.
So remember to dig into your Bibles and continue to explore this indescribable God, because He has created so many things, and He has created you with a purpose and a plan. And we're going to be discussing a little bit more of that in the coming weeks ahead.
Oh, yeah.
So continue to worship with us in a few moments. And until next time,
take care. And God bless.
Bye.
Bye now.
From the highest of heights to the depths of the sea, creation's revealing Your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring, every creature unique in the song that it sings, all exclaiming, indescribable, uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and You know them by name. You are amazing. Awestruck, we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim, You are amazing, God. From the highest of heights to the depths of the sea, creation's revealing Your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring, every creature unique in the song that it sings, all exclaiming, indescribable, uncontainable. You place the stars.